J March, Wiki Malcolm in the Middle. Lost episode. Let me take you back to 2003 when Malcolm in the Middle had a mysterious unaired episode entitled Francis Flashback. This episode was filmed between April through September 2002 for a potential March 23, 2003 air date during the fourth season, but the Fox network mysteriously cut from the airwaves due to many uncertain speculations. I worked at the Fox Broadcasting Network as a video programmer at the time, and I've gotten a few dozen emails speculated that this was because of poor timing and it was during a war going on, which explained why a few seconds of the opening was interrupted by a news broadcast of the War on Terror in Mid to West Coast affiliates. Those who have seen that few seconds opening at the time recalled Francis purchasing an M13 firearm before running out and causing a mass shooting. There were complaints after complaints, half of which seemed out of character for the poor feller making the following episode way too violent, while half complained about the episode being interrupted with a special breaking news report about the war, thus feeling overwhelmed and disappointed about the rest of the broadcast during the remainder of that night. The other information I have gathered were from cast, crew, executives, and the creator, Linwood Boomer, who worked during the airing of the show. Even though I'm afraid to reveal any details within my behalf of the Fox executives. If you want any information, however, according to the 4th and 5th season DVD commentaries, 3 episodes from the respective seasons, one entitled, Daycare, and the other 2 from season 5, Vegas and Block Party, had some of the same locations reshot and some scripts rewritten to cover up the lost episode. Plus, during a 2015 Reddit Ask Me Anything Malcolm in the Middle 15th anniversary reunion with Frankie Muniz and Breaking Bad's Bryan Cranston, there were a few questions asked about that lost episode, but those questions resulted in a series of permanent shadow bans from Muniz, Cranston, and the mods themselves after feeling annoyed and enraged about being asked these same exact questions over and over again about what happened a decade prior. One other piece of the puzzle is the tape in question. The production code for that episode was originally 0602422, which explains why if you look up the Malcolm in the Middle's episode list on its official archived website, Wikipedia, IMDb, or anywhere else, the episode clip show to just weeks prior, has always been the production code. Little did anyone know, that same production code was the one just to cover up the unaired episode in question and is labeled as 0602422B. The other one, known as Francis Flashback and has been labeled 0602422A, has been hidden under Fox Sports footages of all places. The tape is still in my possession under the network's oath, and I'm afraid I have given you many behind-the-scenes information. I will, however, do my best to describe in detail the episode in question. The episode opens up with an overhead view of Malcolm awaking from what seemed to be some kind of awful experience he's been experiencing as of that moment. He looked noticeably worrisome, lonesome, and even a bit jerky at times. There was no narration spoken by Malcolm, there wasn't any music playing, or sound effects, or even just straight up sound playing for the whole 1 minute scene. Nothing but silence for this one whole scene alone. The entire one scene, consisting of one reverse shot, two overhead view shots, and one bird's eye view shot, is with Malcolm looking in the window, noticed his friends and family were dead for a few weeks or have been on the verge of dying. His room was in a complete mess, dirty fabric all over the floor, leftover dishes, While the show is about the titular middle child being the outcast of the family, just not in a very unusual, depressing state. At that point, the audio began working with Lois furiously knocking on Malcolm's door. He opens the door and she hands him the telephone while she is seen sobbing rather loudly, depressingly, and hysterically, all at once. She says it's Francis and he has written his manifesto about his life and his awful deeds of what he has caused. Francis explained the reason on speakerphone and what he may do next. I'm sorry, Malcolm. It's not you who's been in deep suffering throughout your miserable life. Just remember to take care of yourself. Don't tell the CIA, the FBI, or the mass media. Malcolm hung up the phone after a millisecond of static noise, and both he and Lois were in fear by what they have just listened to. Keep in mind, their reaction and their faces didn't seem to look comedic, but more painful. Malcolm breaks character for a second as he said quietly, I'm sorry, I can't continue. I gotta leave. You could hear several crew members and directors mumbling while he tries to exit the stage and phone his agent, but yet the guards keep pushing him back on set. However, this isn't the worst part. The next scene features a funeral home with Malcolm and Dewey sitting at a black cloth dinner table. Malcolm gets up from his seat as the scene cuts to the blowing of leaves coming from the trees. Camera pans out and Malcolm looks down. Dewey gets up from his seat and stared at Malcolm and, you know, this is hard to explain, but the scene cuts to both of them watching on TV the presidential speech from Barack Obama about the Star City shooting. I giggled inside. Remember, we shot the episode back in 2002 and this was supposed to air during season 4. Even more so is that the TV they were watching was an Amazon Prime TV with Alexa included. In the final scene, it was back to Malcolm's room where he woke up out of bed, scared as hell, as if it were some horrifying nightmare. I mean, given that whole entire traumatizing experience, I wouldn't blame him. Malcolm walks downstairs to the kitchen and he greets Dewey a good morning. Dewey, however, asks him, say the other day at school, we were doing a show and tell, and I showed a collection of lizards. Wanna see some? Malcolm snickered and said, come on, Dewey. Don't you understand? We are the lizards. The camera then panned slowly to his face as his eyes became slivered like almonds. The episode abruptly ends right after this scene. The episode is 9 minutes long, unlike other episodes. The show's runtime clocks in usually 22 to 23 minutes without commercials. Following afterwards is 14 minutes of dead air. The rest of the tape contains news broadcasts recorded over by the network. One being a report about a swine flu outbreak, the other being a hurricane hitting in New Orleans. The third being a stock market recession in 2007-8, the fourth being the Boston Marathon bombings, and the final one. J March Wiki, Malcolm in the Middle, Lost Episode. Let me take you back to 2003 when Malcolm in the Middle had a mysterious unaired episode entitled, Francis Flashback. This episode was filmed between April through September 2002 for a potential March 23, 2003 air date during the fourth season, but the Fox network mysteriously cut from the airwaves due to many uncertain speculations. I worked at the Fox Broadcasting Network as a video programmer at the time and I've gotten a few dozen emails speculated that this was because of poor timing and it was during a war going on, which explained why a few seconds of the opening was interrupted by a news broadcast of the war on terror in Mid to West Coast affiliates. Those who have seen that few seconds opening at the time recalled Francis purchasing an M13 firearm before running out and causing a mass shooting. There were complaints after complaints, half of which seemed out of character for the poor feller, making the following episode way too violent, while half complained about the episode being interrupted with a special breaking news report about the war, thus feeling overwhelmed and disappointed about the rest of the broadcast during the remainder of that night. The other information I have gathered were from cast, crew, executives, and the creator, Linwood Boomer, who worked during the airing of the show. Even though I'm afraid to reveal any details within my behalf of the Fox executives. If you want any information, however, according to the 4th and 5th season DVD commentaries, 3 episodes from the respective seasons, one entitled, Daycare, and the other 2 from season 5, Vegas and Block Party, had some of the same locations reshot and some scripts rewritten to cover up the lost episode. Plus, during a 2015 Reddit Ask Me Anything Malcolm in the Middle 15th anniversary reunion with Frankie Muniz and Breaking Bad's Bryan Cranston, there were a few questions asked about that lost episode, but those questions resulted in a series of permanent shadow bans from Muniz, Cranston, and the mods themselves after feeling annoyed and enraged about being asked these same exact questions over and over again about what happened a decade prior. One other piece of the puzzle is the tape in question. The production code for that episode was originally 0602422, which explains why if you look up the Malcolm in the Middle's episode list on its official archived website, Wikipedia, IMDb, or anywhere else, the episode clip show to just weeks prior, has always been the production code. Little did anyone know, that same production code was the one just to cover up the unaired episode in question and is labeled as 0602422B. The other one, known as Francis Flashback and has been labeled 0602422A, has been hidden under Fox Sports footages of all places. The tape is still in my possession under the network's oath, and I'm afraid I have given you many behind-the-scenes information. I will, however, do my best to describe in detail the episode in question. The episode opens up with an overhead view of Malcolm awaking from what seemed to be some kind of awful experience he's been experiencing as of that moment. He looked noticeably worrisome, lonesome, and even a bit jerky at times. There was no narration spoken by Malcolm, there wasn't any music playing, or sound effects, or even just straight up sound playing for the whole 1 minute scene. Nothing but silence for this one whole scene alone. The entire one scene, consisting of one reverse shot, two overhead view shots, and one bird's eye view shot, is with Malcolm looking in the window, noticed his friends and family were dead for a few weeks or have been on the verge of dying. His room was in a complete mess, dirty fabric all over the floor, leftover dishes. While the show is about the titular middle child being the outcast of the family, just not in a very unusual, depressing state. At that point, the audio began working with Lois furiously knocking on Malcolm's door. He opens the door and she hands him the telephone while she is seen sobbing rather loudly, depressingly, and hysterically, all at once. She says it's Francis and he has written his manifesto about his life and his awful deeds of what he has caused. Francis explained the reason on speakerphone and what he may do next. I'm sorry, Malcolm. It's not you who's been in deep suffering throughout your miserable life. Just remember to take care of yourself. Don't tell the CIA, the FBI, or the mass media. Malcolm hung up the phone after a millisecond of static noise, and both he and Lois were in fear by what they had just listened to. Keep in mind, their reaction and their faces didn't seem to look comedic, but more painful. Malcolm breaks character for a second as he said quietly, "I'm sorry, I can't continue. I gotta leave." You could hear several crew members and directors mumbling while he tries to exit the stage and phone his agents, but yet the guards keep pushing him back on set. However, this isn't the worst part. The next scene features a funeral home with Malcolm and Dewey sitting at a black cloth dinner table. Malcolm gets up from his seat as the scene cuts to the blowing of leaves coming from the trees. Camera pans out and Malcolm looks down. Dewey gets up from his seat and stared at Malcolm and, you know, this is hard to explain, but the scene cuts to both of them watching on TV the presidential speech from Barack Obama about the Star City shooting. I giggled inside. Remember, we shot the episode back in 2002 and this was supposed to air during season 4. Even more so is that the TV they were watching was an Amazon Prime TV with Alexa included. In the final scene, it was back to Malcolm's room where he woke up out of bed, scared as hell, as if it were some horrifying nightmare. I mean, given that whole entire traumatizing experience, I wouldn't blame him. Malcolm walks downstairs to the kitchen and he greets Dewey a good morning. Dewey, however, asks him, "Say, the other day at school, we were doing a show and tell, and I showed a collection of lizards. Wanna see some?" Malcolm snickered and said, "Come on, Dewey. Don't you understand? We are the lizards." The camera then panned slowly to his face as his eyes became slivered like almonds. The episode abruptly ends right after this scene. The episode is 9 minutes long. Unlike other episodes, the show's runtime clocks in usually 22 to 23 minutes without commercials. Following afterwards is 14 minutes of dead air. The rest of the tape contains news broadcasts recorded over by the network. One being a report about a swine flu outbreak, the other being a hurricane hitting in New Orleans. The third being a stock market recession in 2007-8, the fourth being the Boston Marathon bombings, and the final one. J March Wiki, Malcolm in the Middle, Lost episode. Let me take you back to 2003 when Malcolm in the Middle had a mysterious unaired episode entitled, Francis Flashback. This episode was filmed between April through September 2002 for a potential March 23, 2003 air date during the fourth season, but the Fox network mysteriously cut from the airwaves due to many uncertain speculations. I worked at the Fox Broadcasting Network as a video programmer at the time, and I've gotten a few dozen emails speculated that this was because of poor timing and it was during a war going on, which explained why a few seconds of the opening was interrupted by a news broadcast of the War on Terror in Mid to West Coast affiliates. Those who have seen that few seconds opening at the time recalled Francis purchasing an M13 firearm before running out and causing a mass shooting. There were complaints after complaints, half of which seemed out of character for the poor feller, making the following episode way too violent, while half complained about the episode being interrupted with a special breaking news report about the war, thus feeling overwhelmed and disappointed about the rest of the broadcast during the remainder of that night. The other information I have gathered were from cast, crew, executives, and the creator, Linwood Boomer, who worked during the airing of the show. Even though I'm afraid to reveal any details within my behalf of the Fox executives. If you want any information, however, according to the fourth and fifth season DVD commentaries, three episodes from the respective seasons, one entitled Daycare, and the other two from season 5, Vegas and Block Party, had some of the same locations reshot and some scripts rewritten to cover up the lost episode. Plus, during a 2015 Reddit Ask Me Anything Malcolm in the Middle 15th anniversary reunion with Frankie Muniz and Breaking Bad's Bryan Cranston, there were a few questions asked about that lost episode, but those questions resulted in a series of permanent shadow bans from Muniz, Cranston, and the mods themselves after feeling annoyed and enraged about being asked these same